welcome to our Eucharistic celebration. Together then, let us offer a Hail Mary to the patroness of our parish, Mary, Star of the Sea. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Mahalo. Let us turn and greet one another as we prepare for this celebration. A special announcement. In response to the recent emergency order by the mayor of Honolulu to mitigate the spread of COVID-19, singing during the celebration of the Mass or at any other church gathering is suspended until further notice, and the use of wind instruments is prohibited as well. We will be playing instrumental music during the opening, the offertory, the communion, and recessional. The Alleluia Gospel Acclamation, the responsorial psalm, and all of the Mass parts will be recited. Today, we celebrate the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider for this Eucharist is Father Pat. Please stand to begin our celebration.
To you all the day long. O Lord, you are good and forgiving, full of mercy to all who call to you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, suffering enters the life of everyone. As Christians, we are all invited to recognize it as an invitation to share the cross of our Lord. Only sin can come between us and the God for whom we yearn in mind and body. And so we ask the Lord to forgive us and have mercy on all our failings. Lord Jesus, you have been our help. You hide us in the shadow of your wings. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your right hand holds us fast. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you call us to take up our cross and follow you. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us. May He forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Lord, the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. God of might, giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. You duped me, O Lord, and I let myself be duped. You were too strong for me, and you triumphed. All the day I am an object of laughter. Everyone mocks me. Whenever I speak, I must cry out. Violence and outrage is my message. The word of the Lord has brought me derision and reproach all the day. I say to myself, I will not mention him, and will speak in his name no more. But then it becomes like fire burning in my heart, imprisoned in my bones. I grow weary holding it in. I cannot endure it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
O God, you are my God whom I seek. For you my flesh pines and my soul thirsts, like the earth parched, lifeless, and without water. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God. Thus have I gazed towards you in the sanctuary to see your power and your glory. For your kindness is a greater good than life. My lips shall glorify you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God. Thus will I bless you while I live. Lifting up my hands, I will call upon your name. As with the riches of a banquet shall my soul be satisfied, and with exultant lips my mouth shall praise you. My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God. You are my help, and in the shadow of your wings I shout for joy. My soul clings fast to you. Your right hand upholds me.
My soul is thirsting for you, O Lord, my God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. I urge you, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to offer your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, your spiritual worship. Do not conform yourselves to this age, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind, that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good, pleasing and perfect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia.
May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ enlighten the eyes of our hearts, that we may know what is the hope comes to our call.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you.
Jesus began to show his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer greatly from the elders, the chief priests, and the scribes, and be killed, and on the third day be raised. Then Peter took Jesus aside and began to rebuke him. God forbid, Lord, no such thing shall ever happen to you. He turned and said to Peter, get behind me, Satan. You are an obstacle to me. You are thinking not as God does, but as human beings do. Then Jesus said to his disciples, whoever wishes to come after me must deny himself, take up his cross, and follow me. For whoever wishes to save his life will lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. What profit would there be for one to gain the whole world and forfeit his life? Or what can one give in exchange for his life? For the Son of Man will come with his angels in his Father's glory, and then he will repay all according to his conduct. Brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
A young man named Ronnie was a popular high school guy. He was a heartthrob, and he was the team captain of the high school basketball team. Because of his ability, a lot of big universities were interested to take them as their full scholar to play for the basketball team. And so Ronnie chose one. And so, assured of a free college education, what he was doing weeks before the college opened, he was practicing and training to improve his skills in playing basketball. Then one afternoon, this was just a week before the college, his college studies began, he met a car accident. He was run by a drunk driver on the left side of his car, the driver's side. And so Ronnie was pinned to his car. And it took an hour for the responders to take him out of the mangled car. So his left arm and his left leg were both totally crushed. And so he could no longer, of course, walk with that. So the doctors decided that they had to cut or amputate his leg as well as his left arm. Of course, the incident devastated this young man, Ronnie. His future suddenly became bleak. And he thought to himself, he will be a burden to his parents for the rest of his life. And because of that, he had bouts of depression at times. And so, with this story I told you, we ask the questions, why do we suffer? And why does God allow suffering? Why does God let misfortune wreck the lives of so many good people and bring tears to the eyes of many fine individuals? Why does God indeed allow suffering for good people to suffer? For example, in today's first reading, why did God allow the good man, Jeremiah, to be ridiculed, as we heard in our first reading today? Now, Jesus hints the reason for God allowing sufferings to be experienced by us. He says, and I quote, whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Now what Jesus is saying may sound ridiculous and incredible, even insane, but it's incredible and insane for those who do not have faith. In effect, Jesus is saying, whoever accepts suffering and misfortune for my sake will find a whole new life. And that whole new life will not only be in the coming world, but even right here, in this world as well. And Jesus suggests that this new life will even be a far richer life than the one lost by tragedy. In other words, Jesus is saying that God can use our tragedy to guide us, to guide people into newer and better lives. Take the case of Ronnie in our opening story. We left him stuck at his home, having bouts with depression at times. But a year or two had passed, one day Ronnie was watching a television show of people who were actually disabled and yet were able to find new passion in life in spite of their predicament. So these are people who discovered that they actually have other talents or skills that they never thought they had. And so are people who find just the bright side of life in spite of their predicament, of their misfortune. And so as Ronnie was watching the show and hearing the testimonies of these people, he thought back on his younger days when he was just a boy. He recalled that he used to draw, he loved to draw, but you know, that interest faded as he grew older and became a teenager. And so watching again and hearing the testimonies of these people, he drew inspiration from them. And so he thought, you know, of starting this hobby that he used to have, but instead of drawing, he got interested in painting. So he started to paint and paint and paint, and he realized people gave feedback that he is good at it. In fact, during when he would exhibit his paintings, all of his paintings are sold out. So that's how good he was. And so he made lots of money and was able to help his family in the process. He got to be invited also to different schools by principals to talk to the students. So he spoke to them as a motivational speaker, again drawing example or testimony of his own life. And so for this man, young man Ronnie, what seemed to be an incredible tragedy turned out to be an incredible blessing. And so his experience guided him into a new life that surpassed by far the dreams of his old life, and that to become to play in a university for their basketball team, and hopefully, you know, he dreamed of being in the professional basketball league. And so, my brothers and sisters, how do you apply this in our lives, the story of this man, Ronnie? Now, if you are a young person today who dream of making maybe the basketball team or volleyball team or a school or athletic team, but that act, well, we should pick up our cross and follow Jesus. Jesus can lead us to a far richer life as he did to Ronnie. Or if you are an older person who dream of being a successful man or woman in business, or maybe who dream of having the world's greatest family, or maybe dream of having the greatest marriage, but ended up none of this, then again we should pick up our cross and follow Jesus. Jesus can mend or fix our broken dreams and lead us to a renewed appreciation of life that we never thought or imagined possible. And so my brothers and sisters, Jesus reminds us again and again, our sufferings and misfortunes are a mystery, but the church through her saints teaches us that if we live our suffering as a participation in the suffering of Christ, or his pain and passion, then our sufferings become redemptive for us. Then it has great value not only for ourselves but for the church. I remember always this young, parishioner to us. I call her like a living saint, and she suffers a lot of pain in her body. And then I would ask her, "How are you doing?" And she said, "Well, I'm still with all the pains that I feel." And I said, "But," she said, "I always remember." She said, "I always remember the words of the saints that our suffering is a powerhouse of grace." And so every time I feel this pain, I just pray for the souls in purgatory. And that's a wonderful attitude, again, mindful always that our participation, our sharing in the passion of Christ by accepting and living our pains and sufferings freely and generously, did indeed our sufferings become redemptive for us. And so our pain and suffering becomes a participation in the passion of Christ again, if like Jesus, we accept it freely and generously. When we have to carry our cross in life, and certainly we will, all we can do, and what Jesus is telling us, is to trust in him. For he says, and I quote again, "Whoever loses his life for my sake will find it." To understand the true answer to the why of suffering, we must look at the revelation of the love of God, who is Jesus. In his apostolic letter, Salvifici Dolores, paragraph 13, John Paul II said, and I quote, "Love is also the richest source of the meaning of suffering, which always remains a mystery. We are conscious of the insufficiency and inadequacy of our explanations. Christ causes us to enter into the mystery and to discover the why of suffering as far as we are capable of grasping the sublimity of divine love." End quote. And so, my brothers and sisters, we may never fully understand suffering because, as we say, it's a mystery or a misfortune of our life. But then I believe this one is certain, that we will understand suffering and misfortune in heaven. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Please stand, and together let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered, died, and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Like the psalmist raising hands in prayer, we lift up our hearts confidently to the God who receives our petitions.
We pray for our spiritual leaders, that by word and example, they may show us how to accept suffering in the spirit of Christ. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for our persecuted sisters and brothers in every part of the world, that they may persevere in faith and courage, and that their trust in God will never fail. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that students and teachers returning to school will approach their challenges with a love for learning. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for human traffickers and drug pushers, and for all who cause harm to others, that they may recognize the evil they do and be brought to a change of heart. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the members of our communities who are sick and homebound, especially Stephen Achong, our family members, those listed in our parish book of intentions, and those who care for them, may they encounter God's holiness and healing in the midst of their trials. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died, especially Father Dennis Stike, Joan and William Robinson, our family members, parishioners, and all the souls in purgatory, may enjoy the eternal peace and rest of God's heavenly home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the intentions of those in the medical field responsible for public health, doctors, nurses, and all hospital personnel, and those responsible for public safety, especially the firefighters, EMS, police, and military personnel, and for their families worrying at home. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions of John Leong and all of us gathered here, those spoken aloud and those held in the silence of our hearts. For these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Lord God, as we give thanks for the example of your Son, we pray that we may have courage to follow him as his true disciples. And we make these prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Please rise. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May this sacred offering, O Lord, confer on us always the blessing of salvation, that what it celebrates in mystery, it may accomplish in power through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so, with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration, we acclaim. Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy this gift we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world. For by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Larry, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There, we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. my brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Thank you. Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and steer us to serve you in our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a few announcements.
Volunteers are needed to help disinfect and sanitize the highly touched areas inside and in front of our church after Mass. Mahalo for all your help. Just as a reminder, a face mask to cover the mouth and nose should be worn at all times by all who attend Mass. For parishioners and ministers with respiratory issues, it is suggested that a face shield may be used. Singing during the celebration of the Mass or at any other church gatherings, as mentioned earlier, is to be suspended. All parishioners are discouraged from walking through the school campus to the church and parish office from Malia Street during school hours to avoid contact with our students. Please pass instead through Ainakoa Street or the underground parking. Thank you all for coming together to worship as God's family. We look forward to celebrating with you next Saturday and Sunday, and wish everyone a grace-filled, faith-filled, safe and healthy week ahead. As God's stewards, let us all be continually involved together in our parish community. Mahalo and have a blessed evening.
Please rise. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our life.
Amen.